Oh, hey everybody, this is Rufo and then Batt. Say hello, Mr. Batt.
Hello, everyone.
And we thought that for today it might be nice if we watched and critiqued some of the old videos that we used to watch on the MTV when we were young. You know, Batt, you and I, even though we lived hundreds of miles apart, me and Wilmington, Delaware, and you in, where are you from?
Paramus, New Jersey.
Paramus, New Jersey, up there in Bergen County. We watched the same TV at the same time. And later in life, when we met each other, we used to have that common, you know, conversations because we both grew up with the same shows at the same time of day and the same memories. A lot of these videos, these early MTV videos make us laugh, huh, buddy?
Fantastic. You can definitely tell that the quarantine is getting to us.
We're starting to lose our minds. So now we're doing a revised, the Italian Beavis and Butthead version of looking at old videos. And
you're going first.
What's that?
You go first.
I'll go first. We don't know what each other picked.
That's correct.
So we're going to surprise each other.
Right, and we might not play the whole video, we'll do a little, you know, just so you get the flavor of it.
Yeah, and this is our first show, and you can let us know if you like it, how we're doing. We'll break in the middle and have some commentary. There's a few things I'm sure we want to laugh and talk about. So what I'm going to do now is I'll go first, and I will pick a song that I know Batt is very familiar with, a group that he's very familiar with. Here's the thing about Batt in music. While I enjoy music and it makes me smile, he is actually quite the guru when it comes to dates and facts and figures. I do tip my hat. He knows little things about bands and about music. He was more of a student of music and MTV, while I was more of a passive listener. We both laugh at the stuff, but he might even know some little trinkets.
Always wanted to be a DJ.
There you go. That'd be nice. Wolfman Batt. All right. So what we're going to do now is here's my video. Let's see if he can identify it from the opening scene here on the video. You know where we are? Where are we? What part of town?
We're in Greenwich Village.
Greenwich Village. What year would you say this is? 82?
This is the Tattoo You album, so I would say 81. 81. Making a bunch of Rastafarians.
Yeah, he's just sitting there with three Rastafarians. There's Mick Jagger with white pants, nice silk shirt and a hat. And he's getting ready to boogie down. Love this video. This is one of those early MTV videos. And if you remember, they would come on 6-7 times a day.
Right.
Same video, because they only had so many videos. So I remember seeing this video a lot. It had a lot of play when MTV first came out. And I remember very, very little in as far as production value. You can tell somebody came up to Mick and the Stones and said, listen, they're doing this new thing called video. We got to make a video. And I think they just put this together in about a half an hour. What would
you gotta remember, the Stones were around for almost 20 years at this point, doing concerts all over the world.
Sure.
But for them to do a video, they were probably, you know, stoned out of their minds. Like, all right, let's do this, you know, for this MTV.
And let's check it out. All right. So we start off and Mick is sitting on the steps. Here we go. This guy, right away.
Love that they kept that guy in the video.
Who's that guy?
We loved that he was in the video.
I remember, like, just remember we were wondering, who is this guy? He's just, I wonder, was it an accident?
He probably lived somewhere, you know, Soho.
And just walks right by. He's drunk. Middle of the day.
Oh, man. I mean, bobbing and weaving. Guy with the backpack.
What's that?
See the guy in a backpack and a girl in red on the steps.
A young Weird Al Yankovic.
Or Bob Rakowski.
Bob Rakowski.
And you know, you can just tell they're like, all right, stand on the stoop, the steps of this brownstone.
Mm-hmm.
And here comes, you know, here comes Keith Richards. Just let him stroll by, cigarette burning.
Threat in hand. Totally, you know, half into a heroin nod here. You'll see. Switch down. Great. I'm staring at the guy.
Can you imagine what the producers told these three dudes? I mean, honestly, they might be like bicycle messengers, you know, in Manhattan, down in the village. And they're just like, yo, just hang out, chill, smoke some cigarettes. Mick Jagger with the Velcro sneakers.
I just caught that with the Velcro sneakers.
In 81, what the hell? Oh,
that's early for Velcro.
Oh, that's great.
He was a trendsetter.
Oh, keep it rolling.
These two walk by too. There he comes.
Dagger it in. That's great. Sits in between them.
Just sits right down in between. Just has to like go like this.
Right. He's like, hey man.
Hey, man. And the black guy's like, what's up?
That's great.
Look at the smile on his face.
He's bobbing his head, can barely keep it together.
Now, I don't know where they decide to get up, take a walk.
This I remember that face from, you know, 29 years ago. Jesus,
I have no idea.
Years ago.
Why is he here? You got early product placement.
And he's drinking, and you can tell that that's a pop top. That's an old school Miller Lite can that they ripped, one of that they got rid of because it killed the birds.
Sure. That heavy aluminium can.
Yeah, you couldn't crush them.
Holes in the t-shirt. And again, this mile away stare. I don't know, was this guy in the window anyway, and they just captured him?
They
put him in there?
Sit there, right.
There you go, tattoo you in the back.
There it is. Yeah, hit pause, Danny. They're at the St. Mark's Bar and Grill.
Yeah.
Down in the village where I used to, you know, when I was in my truck driving days. You know, St. Mark's Place, very notorious down in Greenwich Village for, you know, a lot of the counterculture, you know, I guess today we would call like the hipster, you know, era. But St. Mark's Place was huge.
You get the old Dutch cleaners in the back. Walking to the bar. This guy.
Of course, who happens to be there, right?
The other is the bandmates.
Right. You got right behind Keith is Ron Wood.
Ron Wood's here.
Charlie Watts and Bill Wyman in the background.
And they are interestingly separated from the other group. Because these were the two straight guys as far as you didn't hear much about them partying like the other guys.
Now, Wyman was the quiet one, and Charlie Watts just had that face when he played the drums.
Wild. Here we go. There's the beer. Fixing them up.
Great.
Now they decide that they're going to hit the stage. Hey, there's instruments.
Yeah, let's just jump up and play.
There we go.
Oh, man.
And Mick gets ready to do the classic Mick Jagger saunter over to the stage. I love this part.
And again, don't discount the random people at the bar.
Just sitting there.
Middle
of the afternoon. This guy's got a Heineken. There we go. We can start playing.
And now they're just jamming. They're, not playing their instruments, but they're, just doing their thing. Oh, it's great. What memories.
Classic little video there. So I like this. I started our little new show out with that one. And I think the Stones were kind of famous for playing little bars in New York, like just out of the blue and stuff. I remember hearing about that.
Yeah.
So that's my pick for our first show today, Waiting on a Friend. So let me get us out of my screen share. And what do you have for me, my friend?
All right. Well, give me a second here.
Let me shut off email. People are trying to get a hold of us. They know what we're up to. Go ahead.
All right. So just give me a second so I can pull mine up.
And the people should know at the end of the day, we'll go to each other's classrooms. And during the day, a music will come in and then we'll go and we'll do this in our rooms.
Yes. And so, we'll get on it and we'll blast it. Okay. Let me switch gears here so I can, first let me introduce my song. I thought about the first song I would do. And again, ironically, we're going to be 1980. So, right at the same time, definitely an artist that is not nearly, the notoriety of Mick and the Stones.
But you
don't even know if I've ever played this song for you before, but let's get into this one. I have chosen Tired of Toeing the Line by Rocky Burnett. So
this is a deep cut.
That it's my specialty. Here we go.
All right.
Or just get on the glasses. Like, there's so much to appreciate.
Wow.
All right. I mean, it's early MTV, so it's that shiny metallic.
Yeah.
Right? And then the random movements. Here we go.
I remember this song. What's going?
The random trombone play. Now there's a horn section in this song, but that's that's just gratuitous tromboning. can we identify that random static line that used to play through videos in the old days of cable?
That was the way TV used to be. You'd get weird little things like that.
You'd be watching, and there'd be this strange, you know, interference in the middle, and then it would go away. Love that it still, you know, exists in this video.
I was a fireman.
I don't know why Rocky.
Where did that come from?
Is a fireman, but the fire truck plays a huge role in his video.
How is a first responder part of this video?
Don't let me waste your precious time. Baby, I'm tired of throwing my life. If you want to get rid of me, baby, maybe, maybe you knew it fine. You know, the early days of the MTV, of the, just videos in general, you know, I was a kid, right? 7-8 years old. I still had a tough time with the concept of the lip sync.
Yeah.
That these videos were basically fake. They weren't playing the instruments.
No.
They're definitely not singing. So, you know, when you see these guys like pick up a guitar, these
spin.
We didn't know. I didn't know that he wasn't really playing.
No.
Should have known. I mean, what the hell's he doing on a friggin' fire truck?
Look at the glasses they give you. Eye exam when they make dilate the pupil. They give you those glasses.
Can you imagine, oh, like the production meeting, if there was one where they sat around and said, all right, Rocky, we're going to put you on the back of a fire engine. We're going to drive through traffic with you on the back of the fire engine. Just keep going through your lyrics.
I guess. Broken heart. Are they women in the band?
I think he had some gratuitous
females
that were not in the band, but they were in the video.
I think the trombone and the guitar player are both women.
Yes. But we're still in that, you know, 70s hair.
Right, right.
You know, couldn't tell except for a beard. Then there's this random spotlight, like used car or, you know, movie premiere spotlight.
This is quite the back arch this woman's got. I don't know if I could ever get back that far. That's way back. They're all women.
Kind of early for the goatee as well. Didn't see many of them in the early 80s.
And if you notice, the classic early 80s, two band members back to back singing into one microphone. That was a big deal back then, too.
That and the clutch of the mic,
we
see in other videos, but here we go, finishing up. Live footage.
Tax dollars used for this fire engine to go out and do this.
I've been holding on. I'm not telling you how it finishes.
I don't remember.
There's an influence here you got to watch for.
All right. Get him out of the water. He hits him over the, he hoses him.
He gets it.
Oh. The sadistic behavior. Keeps playing the trombone, doesn't shake her at all. Look.
Don't stop.
Tired of Tona. And, you know, son of rock and roll, EMI America Records.
Perfect, Danny, because I wanted to point out, again, videos now, nobody who didn't live in our era, you know, knew this. You got the name of the artist.
Mm-hmm.
You got the name of the song in quotes. Then you got the album name.
Yeah.
You got, you know, which record company put it out.
Yeah.
And then the thing at the bottom they added later when the internet came around. All right, let me pull myself out of this one. I thought that would be an interesting start for me.
Yes, very fun song. I think we picked two fun songs from the early years. Why don't you think about one and we'll do this again tomorrow. You game, buddy?
Sounds good.
I'll post this on Facebook and we'll see what kind of feedback we get. And I'll see you again tomorrow. Come up with a good one. I will too.
All right, buddy. Thank you.
Bye, everybody.